Bidenomics fails America, a sobering reality, just in time for the holidays in tonight's preamble. Joe Biden joined 136 countries in seeking to impose a 15% minimum tax on corporations. Joe Biden has been one of the driving forces behind this agreement as governments around the world seek to confiscate more wealth from their people. Corporations don't pay taxes, as you all know. They merely pass on the cost to their customers, hitting the working poor and the middle classes hardest. Biden wants to make sure there are no places on earth that corporations can flee in an effort to provide their products to consumers at a fair price. Biden is consumed with funding government's crazy schemes at all costs, even if he has to steal the rights and autonomy of every citizen in the world. And now America is feeling the weight of Bidenomics. Let's listen to what CNN, hardly right-wing central, had to say about how Americans are faring in Biden's America.
In the overall economy, what else matters to the average American? Gas prices. And gas prices in October 2021, they are at its highest point since October of 2014, $3.19.
Highest gas prices since 2014, you say? Now, what was going on then? Oh, that's right. Another socialist, Barack Hussein Obama, occupied the Oval Office. I'm sensing a bit of a trend here. CNN wasn't too keen on explaining exactly why there's so much pain at the pump for Americans.
Obviously, there are a number of issues as to the reason why, but trying to explain OPEC Plus to a person who has to fill up their tank at $3.19 doesn't necessarily work super well if you're the White House.
OPEC Plus refers to some oil-producing nations around this world. These countries are not increasing their oil production as demand is creeping back across the globe in the wake of the pandemic. Under President Trump, the United States was an energy powerhouse that could simply introduce more oil onto the market, thus driving down the cost per barrel. But since Biden has declared war on American energy producers, taking American energy offline, and since Biden has propped up foreign oil producers, many of them who hate our guts, we can no longer have a significant impact on pricing without greatly reducing our demand. Biden's White House showed their incompetence and lack of control over America's destiny as they begged foreign nations, many of them enemies of the U.S., to increase their oil production. Countries like Iran, Venezuela, and Mother Russia. These countries are profiting and financing their militaries off the extra revenue generated by Biden's backward policies. And by the way, all of that extra money that you're paying at the pump goes to help countries considered enemies by real Americans. Speaking of enemies, there's another issue we are burdened with in Biden's America.
And another looming and very real issue going on, the supply chain. Take a look at some of these headlines. America is running out of everything. Christmas at risk. A supply chain disaster only gets worse. Your holiday turkey may be harder to come by this season.
Wow. Americans are dealing with shortages across the board. The United States, at the behest of short-sighted American politicians, have sent our supply chains to communist China. Communists are having significant issues meeting their obligations, not to mention the fact they're an enemy of the United States. But just look at those headlines. Many of them left-wing biased information sources. The Atlantic. America is running out of everything. From Bloomberg. Christmas at risk as supply chain disaster only gets worse. From the Business Insider, a center-right publication. Your holiday turkey may be harder to come by this season. And from left-leaning CBS, why your kids' toys might not get here in time for the holidays. Isn't life fun under socialist rule? The puppet masters who are pulling a willing Joe Biden strings are widely successful. They're empowering government. They are stealing your rights and freedoms to do so. And they're doing all of this with little opposition from the alleged opposition party. When a nation dedicates itself to taking care of government first, the people are always lost in the shuffle. America's elites are joining elites from around the globe to make sure you and your family are brought to heel. Socialists and collectivists are, by their nature, miserable people. And they delight in sharing that misery with everybody else. You know, I like to tell you this is going to get better, but with dedicated left-wing extremists ruling over us, I can't in good conscience tell you that will be so. I can hope. I can hope enough of our fellow citizens are finally fed up with mediocrity that comes from left-wing thought and government. Maybe our fellow countrymen will begin to demand we return to being great, a return to being the United States of America. Hope springs eternal.
Hi, Rob Carson here. If you love watching Newsmax, you're really going to love listening to our new podcast. It's called the Newsmax Daily. I host it, and I give you the best briefing of the big news of the day, top newsmaker interviews, and even, yes, a few laughs. I know it's hard to believe. So if you're driving, walking, exercising, just about anywhere, you can connect with the Newsmax Daily with me, Rob Carson. Find our podcast online or go to iPhone, Spotify, iHeart, Stitcher, and more, and start listening today.